One of the questions that the My Courses for Faculty Support team gets a great deal is, where do I set my dates? Do I set them in the content area here? Do I set them in the submission review area on discussions, Dropbox, and quizzes? Well, it's not such an easy answer because it really depends on a number of factors and personal preference. Plus, you should know there actually is a third area that allows you to make changes and update and delete all dates on all content, and it's a cool tool called Manage Dates. So what this tutorial is going to do is go through the different considerations, let you see what area you want to choose. Again, it's really up to you. So let's start with the content area. Some of the things to consider here is that when you set the dates here, you can set all three. You can set a start, a due, and an end date on all content. Now, when you set dates within the course content area, the dates are automatically sent to the calendar, whether you want it to or not. Some faculty don't want everything on the calendar. And so what you'd have to do is, after you set the dates in the course content, you'd have to go to the calendar item and delete them. Now remember, if you add just a start date, that date will appear on the calendar. If you add both a start and an end date, then the end date is the only one that appears in the calendar. And if you add a due date and an end date, both of those will be on the calendar. If you add just a due date, just that will appear in the calendar. Now, the other thing to consider here is, what's the process for setting dates? Well, in the course content area, I have to click on a module. Now, I can click on bulk edit if I want, which is kind of nice, and I can click on each one. Or if I'm not setting dates on those, I can click on the little arrow and click edit properties in place, click add set dates, and I add them here. Again, keeping in mind that setting dates here put the item onto the calendar automatically. Now, setting dates on discussions is a whole nother little world. If you set a date on discussion, whether it's an add date or a start date or an end date, what you're setting there is the visibility. And you should really go and look at the next module, which talks about the special considerations when it comes to discussions. So that's the content, course content area. What about the submission review area? Well, in the content area, you can set start, end, and due dates. In the submission review area, if it's a discussion on a topic here, you can set just a start and end date and not a due date. If it's a quiz and you want to edit the quiz, and you go to restrictions on the quiz, you can just set a start and an end date. So if you set due dates on the content area for these items, they don't show up here. If I go to the Dropbox, that's the one tool that's a little different, because in the submission review area with Dropboxes, I can set under restrictions here both start, end, and due dates. Now, you'll notice the dates do not automatically go to the calendar except on the Dropbox, because you don't have a little checkbox to add to the calendar. But when it comes to quizzes, for example, or discussions, when I go to edit those and go to the restrictions area, you'll notice that I can, once I checkbox that has an end date, I can display it in the calendar. So you have a choice whether it does or does not. Now, the other thing to consider here is that in the submission review area, I have a listing of all of my discussions, a listing of all of my Dropboxes, and a listing of all of my quizzes. So I have everything here in one place. I don't have to navigate through the modules to find all of that. And again, setting dates on discussions is another whole little special topic, and I'll talk about that in the next module, and you should go view the tutorial that deals with that, because there's something called availability and locking. So one area you may never have thought of is the Manage Dates tool. And I would suggest going view the tutorial on Manage Dates. I'm just going to show you that the Manage Dates tool is found in the Edit Course area, and it's under Manage Dates. And what this does is, this allows you to see all content, all discussions, all quizzes, all Dropboxes in one place. So one of the other nice things with this tool is that I can choose a specific tool and checkbox discussions and apply filter, because there's very powerful filters here and even filters on between an end date and a due date and all of that kind of stuff. And what I can then do here is go to edit date, and I can then change the date here. Now notice again, when you add the dates here, you do not have start and you do not have a due date. All you have is start and end date. And again, it doesn't display in the calendar automatically. Here I have to change it and put it to the calendar. Now one of the interesting things, if I go to Dropboxes and apply filter and I go to edit the dates here, you'll notice that even in the Dropboxes area here within the manage dates, you have no due dates. So when it comes to due dates, if that's what you want to do, you set those all in the course content because that makes perfect sense. Whereas the other items, you don't have access to that, to those due dates to change those. So again, it's really up to you what area you use, how you use it. It's your choice. There's really no right or wrong. It's how you feel comfortable and how you manage your own course and managing the dates.